Hello all, Shoestring here. I am inside the two room of my carport, which I've never actually put to use before, but I'm going to now. And to start out with, there isn't any real light in here. I've got the door open, but if I want to come out here in the evening, that won't work. I am going to set some lights up, but at the moment, there isn't any way. So I'm going to set up a quick, easy, inexpensive way to put some lights in, and I thought I would walk you through it as I did it. Okay, we're going to start with a 200-watt inverter. This is just a small one I got from Amazon. I'll put a link to it if you'd like to. Also did a review on it. I can put a link down the description for that as well. But this is a small 200-watt inverter. They run about, $25. I got this from Amazon, but there are several other models just like this you can get. You can also get them from Walmart, all types of 200 watts, sometimes 150 watts. You can get them, I've seen them as cheap as $20, up to about $35, $40. This one, like I said, last I looked was about $25. So $25 inverter. We're also going to use this wet lead acid battery. For the price, this is the most efficient that you can buy. This one right here is an Autocraft deep cycle. Remember, don't get car batteries, please. Get deep cycle marine batteries. Deep cycle will charge over and over again. Car battery really isn't made to do that. How much the charging amps and cold charging really doesn't matter when we're talking about something like this. If you're interested, you can look at the reserve capacity. In this case, it's 210. Not doing all the complicated calculations, just take half of that. 210 will make it 105, and that will be about how much amp hours it is. These last I looked are about $120. You can get them smaller for a little less. Save you $22, by the way, if you do a core, if you turn a core in. A core is simply another one of these batteries that's dead. It doesn't work anymore. And you give it back to them, they take $20 to $22 off. Okay, and like I said, wet lead acid, you should keep it charged all the time, and it's going to take maintenance. You have to check the water. Okay, so let's go on. What we've got now is our little inverter, which I've already hooked up. I have already done a video on how to hook these up. I'll put that down in the link too so you can watch me do it. They're really quite simple. But of course, anything is simple once you've done it already, right? Once you know how, it's easy. So the red and the black are connected, and that's what we're going to do now. We're going to take the red first, and we're going to connect it right there to the battery. Then we're going to take a black. Sometimes you'll get a little spark. Don't worry about it. Those things happen. You get a little spark sometimes. Sometimes you don't. Okay, it is now connected. Black to black, red to red. Make sure it works. We put the little inverter on. There we go. Turned on. Green light. It's running. Now what I did is I went in the back and I found an old lamp I hadn't been using. This is just an old $7, $8 lamp. I put a new LED light in there because they are the most efficient. So I went ahead and did that. And we're going to take it. We're going to plug it in. Just a little lamp. A $25 inverter. Lead acid battery. Go ahead and plug that in. Plugged in and light came on. That's all there is to it. I am out here where there is no power at all. And I want to be able to work out here in the evenings. So I've created my own light source. You can do this as well yourself if the power goes out and you just need emergency off-grid power. And remember now, this is, like the title of this video says, this is off-grid. There is no power around where I'm at right now except what I create. Also, quick point, these batteries as well, never let it get below 12.1 volts or you'll harm the battery. Just at each evening when you're done, charge it back up. I think I showed you, or at least you looked at the, maybe you saw it. I have a solar panel here. It's 100 watts. I'm going to tomorrow be setting it outside behind my tool shed here. Have the wires come in, hook it right up to this battery, and every day it will charge it up, and it will be good to go. Now, some inverters come with LED lights, so it will show you what the voltage with the battery is. This one does not. So if it doesn't, let's step over here real quick. I have a multimeter, a small one. Bought this one at Harbor Freight. About 10 bucks, I think, with the coupon. Very easy to use, and it will tell you what the voltage of your battery is. So if you don't have an LED light, then you want to buy something like this multimeter that will show you what the voltage of the battery is. I also keep several of these kilowatts right here because it will show you how much the lamp, for instance, I'm using right here, how many watts it uses. So I'll now have lights to work in here. While I set this all up, I'm going to build a bunch of shelves. I'm going to move some batteries in here. I'm going to put some permanent lights up there in the ceiling. Yes, the lights will be run by the solar. If you like this type of video, please subscribe and like it. And shoestring